Nationwide Arena on a Saturday night, and the first of two games against the Devils in less than 24 hours. And the Jackets on the ice looking for better things tonight.
Dishes here on the wing, quick shot, Bobrovsky fights it off, loose puck. On the power play at 17.8%. Here in front, Kincaid off the goal post. First, the right pad as he did the splits, and then the puck went right off the near goal post. Wennberg again, cross ice, off the crossbar and into the net. Cam Atkinson with his team leading 25th goal of the year, and it's a power play goal.
He's got the option to shoot, but he looks far side, puts it through a couple players for the Devils. Atkinson with a patient play to corral that puck, and in one motion.
Him along with Ryan Murray are heads up players, and right there with Campbell in the middle and Chaput rotating on the faceoff dot.
Dubinsky and scores from the far board. Seth Jones lets one fly. And he's got his second goal as a Blue Jackets, and what a bullet.
And we've played against teams, and we've seen good teams, including the Blue Jackets, when they're on. Transition is key, and right here, guys are on the same page. Seth Jones, when he gets his puck, you can see he's all ready to shoot. That's why that puck beats Kincaid, because Seth Jones is ready on the right side of your screen, the top of your screen, sorry. He's already fired as he unleashes that puck to Seth Jones, who actually pushes the defenseman back with his speed, and he can see it goes off.
Far side of the ice, the pass for Kalina, broken up by Dalton Prout. Quick shot scores! Boone Jenner sends one through Kincaid, and it's 3-0 Columbus.
Top of your screen. Keeps the play in the offensive zone. How about Boone here? Not thinking pass at all. And I thought he was going to pass his puck. No, think shot. And that's why John Tortorella wants Wennberg to be shooting the puck. Great example of a shoot first mentality. Kincaid is out. Kincaid is out. And we're going to see the veteran goaltender, Yan Dinesh.
Jackets keeping the doubles here on the perimeter. Palmieri in front. Bobrovsky gets a piece of it and covers up as he turns behind him in that blue paint and gets the glove on it. Severson fires, scores! Palmieri able to deflect it in front. It's a power play goal with 7 seconds remaining in the Hartnell Pedaling, 3-1.
That's number one. Number one in points for the Devils, third in hits, and he leads the team in shots. Palmieri does it all here for this team, and this is on the power play. And you can see the heads-up play. Not only the face-off win, but Palmieri right in front of Sergei Bobrovsky. And that little fake.
On to Matt Calvert. Calvert trying to pull the trigger there, but Palmieri gets it back and sends it ahead. Here's a break. Henrique walks in, scores. And a collision with Sergei Bobrovsky. It is the second power play goal for New Jersey this period, and it's 3-2.
Here's the turnover on the forecheck. Oh, sorry, the play by Calvert. Here comes Henrique. There's the puck. It's over the line, and Wes McCauley, the veteran referee, is there adamantly pointing that that puck is in the net. And here's Henrique, makes a move as Golubev's all over him. And you could see Sergei's got to focus on the puck, and he does. And now, at that point, he's got to deal with the collision. He's up. He looks fine in his net. But you can see that puck.
And now Nick Foligno from the left wing fires. And that one off the netting and out. In front scores. Palmieri takes the pass. And the Devils have tied it up.
He's going to get this puck and take a hit. And as this play unfolds, here's the hit right here. He tracks a little bit of attention. And that's when he slides that puck out front.
Matt Calvert for Wennberg. A brand new hockey game, and Bjorkstrand puts the Jackets in front with his first National Hockey League goal. Oliver Bjorkstrand.
And Bjorkstrand, who's got a sneaky shot right there, he just uses it. Didn't have to really use a lot of zip on it, but put it in the perfect place. Top of the net, and there he is watching it.
the fight back from the Jackets. 34 seconds, Jody, after the Devils score. They get another one here from Carlson. Back-to-back goals, and the Jackets now have restored a two-goal lead.
Well, it's the same way. In front of the puck at the net, you can see numbers. Carlson standing there all alone.
And 11 seconds later, William Carlson with his knife. And it's 5-3 Blue Jackets, just like that. Able to get to it as Henrique steps between the two Jacket players, but Bjorkstrand able to keep it in, scores! His second of the period, his second of the night, and second in the National Hockey League.
Well, Oliver Bjorkstrand, you're right, Jeff, second of the night, and he's known for his shot. It's one of his special tools. And right there, it's a quick snapshot and snaps that pass. Yandini, two goals here in the third period, his first two as a National Hockey League player.
Boy, he sure listens to the coach, doesn't he?
Yeah.
2-1, and that'll do it.
Very coachable.
The Columbus Blue Jackets end a three-game losing streak here in the finale of the five-game homestand. A convincing third period and a 6-3 win as the Jackets will scoop up the puck, and I know exactly who Boone Jenner is going to give that puck to. Without a doubt, it'll go to head coach John Tortorella on this his 1,000th game behind a National Hockey League bench. The first American-born coach to reach that lofty plateau.